and welcome back to Transformational Talk. If you're joining me for the very first time, Transformational Talk is just me sharing all the tips and tricks that I've learned throughout the week. If you are a repeat viewer, thank you so much for giving me your screen time. So what are we talking about this week? What do I have to say this week? Before we begin, I just want to remind you that there are no judgments allowed here. If you are very religious, you should probably stop watching right now. I'm a person that's very open. I open myself up to new ideas and thoughts, new theories, new philosophies, and I'm always learning to improve myself. I'm always trying to find ways to better myself and to expose myself to new information. So if you are stuck in your ways, if you are not open to change and open to new ideas, this is certainly not a video for you. Just want to share with you an experience that I've had for a couple of weeks that I've been practicing now that's actually working out perfect for me. I have stopped praying in a traditional way. I've basically changed the way that I pray now. I don't know about you, but when I first started praying, my prayer would be, oh God, thank you, Father. I ask you for this, I ask you for that, I ask you for peace of mind, I ask you for finances, I ask you for riches, I ask you for health. It was always ask, 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 ask. And then at the end, I would show my appreciation, my gratitude, my thanks. And I'll say, thank you for this, thank you for that, thank you for that. It always seemed as if I was asking someone for something. And so my first change in prayer was that I disconnected prayer with that someone. So I stopped thinking that I'm praying to someone. We have somehow found a way to affiliate God with a person, right? We all say he. Well, God is a spirit, and I think that's why our carnal minds can't really understand the relationship that we ought to have with God, is because we think of him as a person sitting on a throne, you know, that's gonna let manna rain from heaven. It's not that. He's a spirit. So I stopped referring to, you know, God as a person, as he, you know, I ask you. And no, he's a spirit. So that's one of the changes that I've made. And I'm sorry if I'm about to go a little too deep for some people. Again, like I said, if you're overly religious, you should probably not watch. You should probably not listen. So that was the first thing. I disconnected God with a person, a pronoun, and I started thinking of him as a spirit. And I thought, if he's a spirit, he's all around me. If he's a spirit, he's in me. And if he's a spirit that's in me, then I am God too. Please don't hear what I'm not saying. Do not hear what I'm not saying. So when I decided to disconnect God with a person, like I've been taught all my life, you know, to pray to this person, even though we say with our lips that we understand that God is not a person, me personally, I believed that that was kind of stagnating my spiritual walk, because I still had in the back of my head that he was a person. So after I decided that I wasn't going to think of God as a person anymore, I decided to stop asking him for stuff. I decided to stop asking him for more money and, you know, health and happiness and joy and peace. I know you probably think, well, why? I stopped asking God for these things because he has already given it to us. He has given us everything. He said in his word that we have dominion and power over this earth, which means I have it. So now, rather than, oh God, thank you so much, I need this, I need that, I have to do this, I have to do that, I now start my mornings off with affirmations. I am strong, I am powerful, I am rich, I am a millionaire, I am bold, I am courageous, I am peace, I am love, I am encouragement. I start my day off with these affirmations, and then I thank God for the things that I'm about to receive. The problem is, we are waiting for God to do something for us. He's not. He's already done it. And I think that's the reason why we pray and pray and pray, and we feel like our prayers don't get answered. You're praying because you're praying for someone to do something for you. You're praying and you're asking God to do something, but God has already done it. We have to do the work now, and that's why I had to pretty much changed the way that I was thinking. Instead of praying and asking God to do these things, I started telling myself that I am these things, that I will do these things, that these things are done. I start replacing the God with I will do, I am, because he's already done it. It's only up to us to do it. And that's why I personally believe that we pray and pray and pray and pray and pray and ask and ask and ask and ask for things, and they never come to pass. They never come to fruition. It's because we are not doing it. God is not going to give you $1 million. He may give you $1 million idea, which you have to act out. But until you actually act on those things, they won't come to pass. I mean, we've heard from time to time, faith without works is dead. Me personally, guilty, said that so many times, but still praying and not doing anything. Guys, we have to stop praying, like, and that's what the atheist people would say. You're praying to someone who can't hear you. You're praying to someone who you can't see or touch. It's because we are asking God to do things that we need to do. He has already given us that power and dominion over this earth. So before you bash this idea, I want you to really consider, when you pray, are you praying asking God to do that thing, or do you believe that you have the power to do it? Because you have to do it. I'm sorry, God is not going to give you that job. You have to go out there and apply. And once you've already applied, you command that that is your job, that that is your accounting job, that you are a doctor, and you go forward saying that. If you continue to go day in and day out praying as if you don't have these things, you would never be able to convince your subconscious mind that you have this thing. But you have it, but you keep asking for it over and over and over. So you have to tell yourself that you have it, that you are it, and that's the magic in affirmations. That's the magic in the secret. You have to tell yourself that you have it. So again, I am open to discussions. I don't want anyone to think that I'm an atheist, because I've been called that before, and that I'm, you know, pinpointing and picking out verses of the Bible and things of the Bible. But I don't pray and ask God for anything anymore, because He has given me everything. And that is why I start my day off with affirmations, and then I go with gratitude, and I end like that. So I'm up for discussion. I just want to tell you why I stop praying and how I pray. No, I don't believe I'm God. And no, I don't believe that I'm higher or better than Him. I just believe, and I'm holding on to the firm belief, that He has given me the power and dominion over this earth. So I'm very happy that I was able to come on and chat with you guys this week. I look forward to speaking with you next week. If you like the video, like, subscribe, comment, and let me know what you're thinking. Have a beautiful day. Remember to be bold, be great, and be beautiful.